America is rich. We have a higher income per person than almost any other country in the world, except for a few tiny ones with lots of oil. And we have $71 trillion in household wealth. But where does that income come from? Everyone knows you can get paid for working. Economists call that labor income, and it makes up about 70% of our total national income. But there's also income that comes from merely owning wealth. This is called capital income. Stuff like rent payments, interest on loans, or stock dividends also give you income. Capital income makes up about 30% of the national total, and you don't even have to work for it. Pretty nice. America has a lot of capital income. If you divided up all the wealth in the country equally, each person would have over $220,000 of wealth, which in turn would produce $15,000 of income each year. Wow! But there's a problem. Ownership of wealth is extremely concentrated. In reality, the bottom half of the wealth ladder owns an average of $349, while the top 1% owns an average of over $16 million. That means the bottom half collects an average of $826 in capital income per year, while the top 1% collects an average of over $764,000 per year. That income is also a big portion of the top 1%'s total. While the bottom half gets little or no capital income, almost 60% of the top 1%'s income is capital income. In fact, since the year 2000, all of the income gains of the top 1% have been capital income, and all without having to lift a finger. But wait, there's more. Ownership of wealth is even more concentrated the further you go up the income ladder. The top 0.1% own an average of $83 million in wealth and collect $4 million in capital income each year. Finally, the top 1% of the top 1% own an average of $420 million and rake in $21 million every single year in capital income. So the richer people are, the greater share of their income comes from capital. Fully 3/4 of the top 1% of the top 1%'s income comes from capital. All this makes capital ownership a major engine of inequality. More wealth means more income, which can be used to get more wealth and more income. The rich get richer and everyone else is left in the dust. Inequality is a big problem. If we're going to fix it, we must confront the problem of capital income.